यस सर, यस सर।
नाउ ओके, नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट योर दिस सब्जेक्ट ऑब्जेक्ट ओरिएंटेड प्रोग्रामिंग। क्लियर? इंट्रोडक्शन टू ऑब्जेक्ट ओरिएंटेड प्रोग्रामिंग। सो बिफोर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट दिस टॉपिक, फर्स्ट वी शुड लर्न हिस्ट्री ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट ओरिएंटेड प्रोग्रामिंग। व्हाई दिस प्रोग्रामिंग केम टू मार्केट, व्हाट इज द नीड। So if we will see history, so first we have a software evolution, how software came into the market. So if we will see software evolution, we have some layers, and every layer having some improvement than previous layer. Clear? So first we have a machine language. Hello. Hello.
Yes, sir.
So all of you know binary number. What is binary number? Can anyone tell me? Hello. Hello.
Hello.
Ah, can tell me what is the binary number? Can you explain number system? Hello, am I audible?
Yes, sir.
So you know or not, at least you respond, you know or not regarding binary number, otherwise I will explain. See, binary number means we have a two number, either 0 or 1. Clear? So this is also called machine language.
Yes, sir.
And you can say this is a low level language. So if we will see history of software, so first we have a machine language, later we have a assembly language, that is called a middle level language, and it can be understood by people as well as machine. Later came procedure oriented language. So it is used to solve our mathematical problem. Clear? And last, now what is the running in market, that is called object oriented programming, that is solve a mathematical problem as well as real world problem. Clear? Hello.
Yes sir.
Okay, now so this is the software evolution. In this way software upgraded time to time, so every layer it's having some extra benefits, you can say some improvement than the previous layer. First we have a machine language that will work on binary numbers, either 0 or 1. Later came into the market assembly language, that is middle level language, and it is the understood by people as well as machine. Third came procedure oriented programming. So just like a C language, that is a procedure oriented programming. So they have some drawbacks, that's why object oriented concept came into the market. Clear?
Yes.
Anyone any doubt you can ask me in this software evolution, how software came? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now we will move next slide. See, so this I took, you can note down this figure. First we have a machine language that will work on binary number 0 or 1. Later it came assembly language. After that procedure oriented language, and finally object oriented language. So these are the layers which is available in software evolution. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Now we will move next. So now we will move, what is the procedural oriented programming? So do you know procedure? Okay, tell me, all of you know what is the flow chart? Do you know, all of you, algorithm?
Hello. Yes, sir.
Can you define what is the algorithm or flowchart? Any activity that will be done on a in systematic way or step by step, that is called algorithm. Clear? So large program can be divided into the small programs, is known as functions. So I think all of you know very well what is a function in C programming. Is it clear?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So object in this procedure oriented programming is totally based on the number of functions. We can divide our program into number of functions. Most of the functions shared global data. So you know what is a global data? Global data means a data which is above the main function. If you know C language, if you will define any data type before main function, that is called global variable. Clear? And data can be moved from time to time, one function to any other function. Function transform data from one form to another. You can transfer a data, a function data, from one function to any other function. Employ top-down approach in programming design. So if we will see the designing paradigm of procedure-oriented programming, it is follow top-down approach. We have a two approach. One is the top-down approach. Second, we have a bottom-up approach. So procedure oriented programming is following the top down approach. Means first we have to start from top, then bottom, and finally last the bottom. Means top, middle and bottom. In this way, procedure oriented programming is used to work. Clear?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Now you can see, this is I took a diagram. You can see first we have a main function. You can see this is the main function. Again, main function divided into the number of function. Function 1, function 2, function 3. Again, function 4 is shared by two function, function 1 and function 2. Function 5 is also shared by function 2 and function 3. And function 6, 7, it is sharing from the function 4. So you can see this is a, we have a following one procedure. First main function, then first function, and some function is inheriting from the previous function. And lastly, last function is inheriting from the middle as well as first function. So this is the structure of procedural oriented programming. Clear?
Yes.
Clear? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
How procedure oriented programming is working? Means we have to divide our programs into number of functions, and each function will be shared by number of functions. So you can see here function 4 is shared by, or you can say function 4 having property of function 1 and function 2. It means function 1, function 2 is the global function for function 4. So this is the, in this way, procedure oriented programming is the used to work. Clear?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
This figure is clear. Anyone, any doubt, you can ask me now. That's why I told, unmute yourself. If you have a doubt, you can ask me now. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now we will move next. Now, it's having some disadvantage. Procedure oriented programming having some disadvantage. What is the first? Global data access. As you can see here, function 4 is accessing two data, means function 1 and function 2. So this is the drawback, means there is no privacy of function 1 and function 2. Any function can access the any function data. So this is the main problem available in procedural oriented programming. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Is it clear how data is sharing? Hello?
Yes, sir.
So now you can see function 5 data. The function 5 is sharing from data function 2 and function 3. Same way, function 7 is sharing data from function 4 and function 5. So means what is the drawback here? There is no privacy of any function. Any function can share any function data. So that is a big problem. Second issue, it does not model real world problem very well. So there is also one more drawback of procedural oriented programming, is because it is not working a real world way which it has to work. So to remove such problem, that object oriented programming concept came into the market. Clear? And the third, we have a no data hiding. You can see here there is no data hiding. Any person can share any person data. So that is also a big drawback of procedural oriented programming. Clear? So to remove such problems, object oriented programming concept came into the market. Or you can say OOPS concept is existing nowadays in a market. Clear? So now we have a modular programming. First we learn software evolution, second procedural oriented programming, third we have a modular programming. So what is a modular programming? It is a software design technique that emphasizes separating the functionality of a program into independent interchangeable modules, such as each contains everything. Now you can see here in this program, this is the main function, main program, or it is dividing into the module, module 1 and module 2. Or inside that module, we used to create a function, function 1, function 2, function 3 and so on. So if you have a programs and if you are making that program in a module, first module, second module, third module, in that module again if you are defining a functions, so that is called a modular programming. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Hello?
Yes, sir.
And all sir. Models, all modules are independent to each other. It means there is no relation of module 1 to module 2. Module 1, module 1 is independent and module 2 is independent. Both modules are independent to each other. Clear? So this is called a modular programming. It means we have to make a module according to our requirement and we can go for our programming. Any doubt, anyone? You can ask me now.
No, sir.
No doubt? Ishwari, Ganesh, Vaishnavi, anyone any doubt?
No, sir.
Ganesh? Ganesh? Are you there, Ganesh? Are you hearing me? Vaishnavi?
Yes, sir.
Any doubt?
No, sir.
Clear? Everything is clear?
Yes.
Clear now? What is the modular programming? What is the procedure oriented programming?
Yes.
Clear or not? If you have a doubt, you can ask me now. Is it clear? Can we move next?
Yes.
If you will tell again, I will explain. There is no issue of time. We have a lot of time. First, concept must be clear in your mind. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now we will go for the next topic. Now came object oriented programming. So what is this object oriented programming? It is a one type of modular programming that is divided into the two parts. First part is the data, second part is the function. Clear? So you can see suppose I am telling, I will take one example. Suppose you are the students, okay? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So now suppose students having name, students having ID, so these are called data. Clear?
Yes.
And yes, suppose you are reading a particular book, you are reading, writing. So this is called function. Reading and writing are the function, or student's name and ID, these are the data. Clear?
Yes, sir.
So object means, object is consist of two parts. First one, data parts, second is the function. So object oriented programming is working on the two parts. First part for the data part, the second part for the, you can say, functions or operations. Clear?
Yes.
Now you can see here, this I took example. This is the procedure oriented programming. So here this we have a global data, and these global data will be shared by functions and local data. The data which is available in this function 1, function 2, and function 3. And now you can see object oriented programming. So you can see this blue box, this is called object. In that object, again we divided into the two parts. First part for the data, second part for the function. Clear?
Yes.
Data means student's ID, student's name, student's college name, that is called a data. Functionality means what is the functions of students, what students can do. Students can read the book, write the notes. So these are the operation of students. Clear? So here you can see these are the three figures. This is the one object, this is the second object, this is the third object. So all are communicating with each other. It means object 1 can communicate with object 2, object 2 can communicate with object 3, and object 3 can communicate with object 1. Clear? So this is called object oriented programming. It means we have one object, or object having two parts. First part is the data, second part is the functions. Clear?
Yes.
Ganesh? Ganesh, are you there? He is not there. Okay. Now we will see next part. Now we have what is the features of object oriented programming. Clear? So first you see, we have a main focus on doing something rather than procedure. Means we have to do work, we have to make only procedure. Programs are divided into objects. So we can divide our program into number of objects. And data structures are designed such a way that they characterize the objects. Means in object oriented programming, everything will be done with the help of object. So functions that operate on data of an object are tied together in data structure. So in a function, you can say function will also consist of two parts. Main, the data. Inside function, data is available. If that function is performing any particular operations, so that will also come into the object. And data is hidden and cannot be used by external function. So what is the problem is available in procedure oriented programming. All person can access the global data. So this problem be removed in object oriented programming. Object may communicate with each other with help of functions. You can see this figure here. These are the communicating. First object is communicating with second one. Second one is communicating third one. Third one is communicating with first one. So in this way, these objects can communicate with help of functions to each other. New data and functions can be added into the object oriented programming. It follow bottom up approach. Clear? Procedure oriented programming followed what? Top down approach, and object oriented programming following the bottom up approach. Clear?
Yes,
sir. Clear, Ishwari, Ganesh, Vaishnavi,
yes,
or not?
Yes, sir.
Anyone any doubt, you can ask me. No doubt? Ishwari?
No, sir.
Clear? Everything clear?
Yes, sir. Yeah.
Can we move next slide? Now see, what are the main concept available in object oriented programming? Clear? So this is very important. Whenever you will give interview everywhere, they will ask these concept. So these are the main features, you can say, or you can say basic concept of object oriented programming. Object, class, data abstractions and encapsulation, inheritance, polymorphism, data dynamic binding and message passing. These seven are the main, or you can say, important characteristics of object oriented programming. Clear? Now yes. We will read these concepts in detail. Clear? Now we will study what is the object, what is the class, what is the data abstractions, what is the data encapsulation, what is inheritance, what is polymorphism, what is dynamic binding, and what is message passing in detail. Clear? Is it clear? Now we will go for the object.
Yes.
So what is the object? Now can see objects are runtime entities in object oriented programming. Clear? For example, object may be any person, a place, a bank account number. So it can be anything which is having runtime entity. So object may be person, also one object is there. You can say any place, Nasik, Pune, Mumbai. These are also object. Bank account also is one type of object. Clear? Second, what I told, object is the combination of data and functions. Clear? So what is the object? The fundamental idea behind object oriented approach is to combine the both data and functions into single unit, and these units are called objects. Clear?
Yes. Yes.
Ganesh?
Hello sir, you can hear me?
Ganesh?
Hello, you can hear me sir?
Your voice is very low, I am unable to hear. Increase your volume.
Hello?
Hello?
Hello, sir. You can hear me?
Now I can hear you. So are you seeing my lecture? Are you listening or not?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Is it clear everything or any doubt?
Yes, sir. Sir, we can say another definition of object-oriented programming. Can I say?
Any definition? Any other Hello? Definition?
Object-oriented programming, what is definition? Real world object converted into the programming words is called as object. That is the real things and non-living things. Living things or non-living things, what is mean by? Real thing means living things means student, employee, any person, and non-living things table, chair, board, fan,
yes,
etc.
Yes, correct. It is also correct.
Correct.
Object may be any
non-living thing.
Maybe any person. It may be living things or it may be non-living things.
Non-living things. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. That
object
is my
object. May be any table object. Also. Object may be student also. Student also one object.
But two parties there. Things, living things and non-living things, sir.
So means we can categorize object. It can be anything. It may be living things or it may be non-living things. Both may be possible. So according to our
my definition is
relevant. If we want living things, we can use that one. If we don't want, we can use non-living things.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. My definition is right, na, sir.
Correct. No problem. It is also correct. What I written, that is also correct.
Okay. Thank you.
I wrote now this. It may represent a person, place, bank account number, or anything may be object.
Yes, yes.
Object means
for
it
example,
is a combination of data
person.
And function.
Function. Sir, function
equal
is method
to you can say data plus function equal to object, or object equal to it is a combination of data and functions.
Sir, can I call the function as a method?
Yes, you can say no problem, method, or you can say operations
okay.
Also.
We can say in C language is a function and Java is a method.
Yes,
it is
yes.
Called method.
See, function is called in C language, method is called in Java, but both are same.
Java method. Okay.
Whatever we are calling function in C, same thing we are calling method in Java.
Okay.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
And now see here. I will take an example. The object means combination of data and program that represents some real world entity. Now you see, for example, consider Amit. Okay, so Amit is one object. Hello,
sir.
So Amit is one object.
Hello?
Now it's having some characteristics. Amit is 25 years old, and his salary 2500. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Now Amit may represented in a computer program as an object. Clear? The data part of object would be age and salary. Clear?
Data part.
This is the data part. Now we will see the functions. So now see retrieve of data, change age, or change of salary. Clear? So this is called function.
Okay.
If you want to retrieve data, if you want to change the age of that function, you have to write one function for changing the age. Clear?
Clear, sir.
If you want to change the salary of employee, again you have to write the change salary function. That in that you can change the salary of that particular employee. So these are called functions. Retrieve of data, change age, a change of salary. This is the function. Simply, what is the age of employee or salary of employee, that is called data. Clear? So now you can see here in the Amit object, name and age.
Function.
That is called attribute of an object. Clear? So these are called attributes. Data and functions are the attribute of object. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Any doubt, anyone? Ishwari, Vaishnavi, Ganesh, if you have a doubt, you can ask me now. Any doubt?
No, sir.
Okay, now see, after 5 minutes, it will be stop automatically, okay? So again, you have to resume. Again, you have to join Zoom links, okay?
Okay.
Now, we go next. Now see, this is the diagram. Is it clear, visible or not?
Visible, sir.
Now see, so, this is the one object. Object A, this is the object B. Now you can see here object equal to data plus methods. And this is the data or this is the function. So now you see object is a combination of data and function.
Clear? Okay. Yes, sir.
So this is object A, this is object B, this is object C. All are communicating. These are the communication. So they can communicate with each other with help of message passing.
Message passing means calling, na, sir? Message passing means calling, na? One function to another function.
They can call each other. Yes, they can communicate with help of message passing.
Yes, sir.
Clear? This image is clear? So this is called object. Object means if anyone asks what is the object, you can tell object is a runtime entity and it is the collection of data and functions. Enough. Clear?
Yes, sir. Okay.
Okay, now we will go for next. Class. Clear? Because class is very important for C++. In C++, class must be necessary. Means must be not necessary, you can say. Class is play very important role in a object-oriented programming. So what is a class? A group of objects that share common property for data parts and some program parts are called classes. Clear? So I will take an example. Suppose there is a fruit class. Clear? There is a one class fruits, and what are the objects? Apple, mango, papaya, banana are the object of fruit class. Is it clear?
Yes, banana, apple is the object.
Yes,
the class.
Apple is the object of fruit class.
Fruit class. Okay.
It means for a single class, you can make number of objects. Okay.
Sir, a class keyword is used for converting the real world object into programming word.
No, that class is that user defined data types.
No. I'm asking only class. We already defined there in program. Class.
No, class is a
keyword. Sorry, predefined word.
Yes, class. That is called keyword.
Keyword, predefined word, reserve word.
Yes, reserve word. You cannot use as an identifier.
Class story in a class.
Class, what you are telling?
Class store in a class.
Class
keyword store in a class, class word.
No, class word is the keyword. You cannot use, it is a predefined in a C++ library class.
Okay. But I'm telling you this class keyword is a predefined word in the class, inside the class.
See, if you want to define a class, you have to write CLASS class or class name.